What is that? Does it do the same?
So perchlorate's also in that family of halides we talked about before. It's a chlorine derivative. And manufacturing processes for fireworks and for bomb manufacturing.
Rocket fuel, too?
Rocket fuel. It's a byproduct of those processes. And the government allows these companies to just dump it back into the sewer system when they make it. And what happens is the wastewater treatment plants don't fully remove it, so we get it back in our water supply.
Do they test your water for it?
I don't believe most companies are testing the water. Most cities are testing the water for it. They believe that small amounts are safe when the studies clearly show perchlorate levels going up.
Okay, so we have the perchlorate, the bromide. Are there any others that are...
We talked about the fluoride.
Oh, right, fluoride.
That's another halide.
Everybody's drinking that almost.
Everyone's drinking that. And that's another thing that's whacking
iodine. Well, no wonder. I think we solved the reason why our iodine levels are dropping.
But you can't find, it's really, really difficult to find toothpaste without fluoride.
Oh, is it?
Even the natural companies have started putting it back in.
It is tough.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Okay, so if we don't have enough iodine, you may get a goiter, but that's not as common as it once was because we've iodinized salt and we have enough for most people to avoid the goiter. But it can also lead to other thyroid disease when you don't have enough iodine. My connection here that I want you to explain, I really want you to understand this. I want everyone to understand this. When our iodine is removed, when we don't have enough, it can make you susceptible to breast cancer and prostate cancer. Help us understand this.
So fibrocystic breast disease, which is affecting over 80% of women, is iodine deficiency, period. Okay. And I've treated hundreds, if not thousands, of women over the years with fibrocystic breast disease just with iodine, and their fibrocystic breast disease goes away.
Wow.
Fibrocystic breast disease is a precursor to iodine, is a precursor to breast cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And basically it's in that continuum of iodine deficiency we talked about in the first part of the show.
Right.
And all this can be reversed and avoided if women would maintain adequate iodine levels.
Well, how do you do that?
In today's world, you're gonna have to supplement with iodine. And you know, I've been doing research on iodine for over 10 years now, and the Japanese ingest about 12.5 milligrams of iodine per day because they eat a lot more seaweed in their diet and a lot more fish in their diet. We estimate that they're ingesting about 12.5 milligrams. So they have markedly less fibrocystic breast disease, markedly less breast cancer, markedly less prostate cancer, probably related to that.
If I use, say, 3 grams of salt or so a day and it's iodized, would that get me close to that 12, 13 milligrams of iodine?
Not even close.
Not even close.
So the RDA for iodine is 150 micrograms per day.
Micro, oh, so that's a lot of zeros first.
That's a lot of zeros. So this is 100 times more than the RDA for iodine we're talking about.
And that's safe to do?
The Japanese do it.
They do it every day.
I have not seen problems with patients that do it. If patients have a specific thyroid problem, a toxic goiter that could take up iodine, that could be a problem with taking iodine, but that's very rare.
Yeah.
People who do that, who have that, when they take their first dose of iodine, they'll get a little hyper and a little nervous and jittery. They won't be able to take it till they get that thyroid problem fixed.
Uh-huh.
The rest of us should be able to take iodine without problems.
Doctor, in your book, you give case studies of people who come and you evaluate them and they're low in iodine and you replace that and you treat that. And some of these patients are breast cancer patients who are looking for an alternative. They don't want to do chemotherapy, radiation, and surgery, and I understand that. And you have described several cases of remission to cancer with iodine therapy.
Well, look, we have 1 in 8 women with breast cancer in the United States right now.
That's wrong. I mean, that can't be, that's a bad thing.
There is very little research going on what's causing this. There's a lot of research on how to treat it, but that's too late at that point.
Right.
And the research seems clear to me. We should be investigating the toxic halides, and we should be investigating iodine deficiency, because I've seen many women with breast cancers or fibrocystic breast disease. Their disease starts to halt when they get their iodine levels up.
That's amazing.
That is amazing. Now, I don't know how much time we have. I got so engrossed in our discussion. We have a couple minutes. What I would like to know is for the people, because, I mean, I've lost personal friends to breast cancer.
Yes.
It's just, I can't even begin to go there. It's so, so widespread. We want to stop it, and we want to stop it today. So I need to tell my friends, you need to start supplementing with iodine. That's just a given.
Well,
right?
I think...